And we need, Angela did a beautiful job by sending us our minutes on Monday, which is fantastic. We have a motion to approve the minutes that she sent us on Monday.
That's a move.
You're so moved?
Yes, I do.
Wow. Aren't there any seconds on the move? All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed?
I think we need to do introductions.
All right.
We can do that, but I'll have to do that.
My name is Amy Mann. I am the chair of the AMA commission, and I did on my fifth year. And it's a great thing to do. I apologize if I'm a little wild and crazy tonight, because we're trying to do emergency contingencies. So, go ahead.
I'm Mary Long.
I'm the coach.
I'm vice chair of the AMA. My term is on June. I've turned it out. I worked for a while.
Hi, I'm the president of the AMA second term.
Hi, I'm Holly Rush. I'm my first term.
My name is John Hanson. My first term is in June. I own a Longmont sign company here in town. Sold, owner operated. So the front door is locked, just call me on my cell phone.
I'm Marsha Martin. I'm your new city council liaison. And I don't know anything about you guys yet, but I'm a good one.
Susan Harwitz, and I've been on commission since June, July.
Angela Barella, I am the Art and Public Places liaison, and I have officially been here for over 6 months. So I think you might be stuck with me.
That was fast.
Right? So fast.
I'm Alexis Newton. I'm the AIP intern. I've been here since October. I'm a graduate student at CU in the Museum of Field Studies program.
I'm Tiger, and I've been here for almost a year.
I'm Laurel Alterman, and I'm on the board of Belgium 2021, and I'd like to encourage all of you to speak up so we can hear you tonight. Thank you.
I'm here, Alexander. I'm about to pursue my first term on the board.
Okay, great. Was there proof of the minutes? Without corrections, correct?
And who, I'm sorry, and we had Cindy moved.
Cindy moved to approve the minutes.
Thank you.
And I think Randy accepted.
And it was unanimous, yes? Great.
Do we have any citizen comments? I'd just like to call Cindy. Going once, going twice.
Do we have any corrections to the agenda?
I don't have anything to add.
Okay, cool. Anybody else have any corrections to the agenda that we need to address? Fantastic. All right, let's go to number five, public art project updates. On your part, Ms. Angela, thank you.
So I can say pleasantly that we have moved forward with the Collier Park, and one of the three steps that needs to happen for finalization has come about, so the artist is working with the rest of the parties that he subcontracted, and once that all the agreements are made, then we will be able to finalize. So I'm hoping within the next 2 months. So
that's great. Yeah, let's go.
Yes.
Did they fix the ground yet?
They did. It's lovely.
Cool.
It's beautiful. As you also know, the city has gone through rebranding process, and so we're looking at what the art labels will be looking like. And so I'm also hoping that Collier Park, Lady and the Damsel, which is out along Dickens, the Greenway, as well as something else, will all have new labels with the new branding. The Dickens Puppies, the rejuvenation, and that will be dedicated this year. And Noah is not here, so 9th and Alpine is in very good shape. We are under contract with the original artist, Patrick Milbury, and he is working on a redesign for us. Once that redesign is done, it will come to you for approval. It will be similar to the original design, but with a more positive message. And Mike, the graffiti specialist, is measuring the underpass for us. The two sealant options that we have discussed previously are about the same price, but he has a preference. The trick with it is Rust-Oleum spray paint actually can penetrate that a little bit more, so we'll want to be very thoughtful about what product we use. So this spring, once the weather gets nice and the design is finalized, that'll be moving along.
Thank you for your hard work on that.
You're welcome.
Excellent. So let's move on. We get some entertainment this evening from our traffic and pedestrian data analysis, Alexis.
Yes.
Welcome, Alexis. We're really glad you're here.
Thank you. Thank you for having me. So, gathered some of the traffic and pedestrian data that we've collected.
Alexis, I'm going to tell you really quickly, we have some people that are a little hearing impaired. Some talk is loud.
You might want to actually stand up so
okay.
Folks can see.
Yeah. Sorry.
No, you're wonderful.
It's a big room.
It
me
is.
Being the loud person, I don't have to.
Yeah. All right.
Okay. You can see here we have three sections on the map. We didn't have data for every single art piece because obviously not all of them are visible from the road. And this is only traffic data, and we have a little bit of pedestrian data as well. But you can see the colored dots are the pieces that are cross-referenced with traffic data points. The number of views are in the thousands per day. So each point collected how many cars passed by in a 24-hour period in that area. And so you see there are many hundreds of thousands of views for each piece per day. The data isn't totally solid, obviously, because the data points are from different years. It's an approximation. And most pieces are generally visible from the road. Some of them might be less so, but I tried to pull from the pieces that were most visible that people would very obviously be seeing when they were driving past. And then you can also see the numbers for some pedestrian views downtown as well. And then the next slide, we just have some examples pulled from Google Maps of the pieces that you can see from the road. So obviously, some of these are very large. People will be familiar with them as we're driving throughout town. And the next piece is the shock art boxes. So out of the 49, 24 of the pieces were visible or were near a data point for the traffic data. And so we have 434.4 total views per day, which is in the thousands. And then there were some data points that were four pieces. The data point could have been from the year before the piece was installed. And so that additional number is kind of an approximation based on previous data. So if a piece went in 2018, but the data points from 2017, that one in kind of the secondary category. But that's
just
a very brief
overview of that. Do you want to share from this data?
Mm-hmm.
We extrapolated some required for SCFD reporting measures, so based upon this data, estimations of some of our programs.
Mm-hmm. Do you want me to?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay.
Absolutely.
So the breezeway pedestrian traffic data total was 136,000.
Art in the Move was about 332,000. The top 10 vehicle visible pieces were 190,000. The rest of public art was approximated to be about 1.2 million. Shop art was 17.8 million, and so the total annual views for all of the pieces is estimated to be about 19.7 million views.
19.7 million views.
What's our population? That's just unbelievable.
What's our population now?
We're close, probably about 100. Right, Marcia?
What? 100? Yeah, just short of 100,000.
Mm-hmm. Census will tell all if we get one.
Yes.
So ways to move forward is obviously asking GIS as they go forward in time of placing their vehicle tracking points to potentially strategically do that along places that we may want to have public art, say in the northern corridor. And then also we have a pedestrian counter in St. Stephen's Plaza. We can move that around. We can also work with LDDA on their pedestrian counters to get more accurate assessments of this. And then it absolutely points that this is a very conservative estimate.
That's really cool that it is.
Good work.
Well, not cool, but now we're going to see what we're going to do with it, right?
Yep. All right.
I'm so thankful for your work on this, Alexis. We really appreciate your time. We know what you need. Okay, great. So let's go ahead and move on to our famous, wonderful Randy, who's going to tell us about the beautiful URSA.
So I summarized last month where we were. I believe most of you guys were here. Do we have anything new?
The only update is we are in conversations with the building owner at 5th and Main, but as most of you know, there is a Goose that is located there, and the building owner and the Goose owner are working together to have that removed, moved to a new location.
Okay.
Moved, relocated. But that's not really art in public places arena, so we stepped back just a little bit, but our contract with the artist is to have the work delivered by spring. If that ends up being the location, we may have to postpone it a little bit.
So it was purchased.
We have received a signed contract.
She is ours.
And well, it's on the mayor's desk, and the mayor's out of town. But yeah, I mean,
really?
We're there.
It's a boy.
First a boy. How do you know that?
It's Ursa Major. He's a big grizzly bear.
You won't go into that.
Does anyone want to see pictures of where the site, potential site is?
Or in full
force. I don't know if it shows numerous information on the
So.
I think the mayor's back.
Oh, good.
He came back early because of the emergency.
So hopefully by the end of this week, we should have signed, and then that's good. Because then the artist receives the first. Do you want me to pull, Yvette, would you like me to pull it up for you?
Okay. Wonderful.
Nope, okay.
Mr. Cities.
We had a meeting. We had a really good meeting. Earlier this week, we discussed the different options for the installation and the cost of what they wanted, and they still don't really have a firm idea. We did preliminary discussions of the RFQ process and the selection committee members. They were, of course, really wanted a lot of sister cities people on the selection committee, but we're limited, so they're limited.
How are they with that, Cindy?
They seem to be okay because
they struggled with that early on.
Their meeting is also tonight. And we sent them off to their meeting with three things they had to do. What did they talk about? They have to decide if they want a monument, a gathering place, or a gateway. They have to confirm that they are okay with Workman Park, which is really all we focused on in this last meeting. as the place because it's still under construction. It would be a great opportunity for us to put something in on the ground. And they have to determine a firm donation amount that we will match. Because they're like 10 or 15 or maybe 20, but about 10. And so we're like, before we can put on RFQ, we need to tell them we can pay these people, so we need to know what you're going to donate and we will match.
And can I ask you real quick, when this amount comes out, I'm sure you're going to be in contact. And we're all in limbo right now with what our meetings are going to be like. Would you be willing to let us know what they come up with?
Oh, yeah. So we're meeting again at the end of this month. So the next meeting we should have, hopefully, have the
next. We may not have a next meeting, so that's what I'm saying. Just be prepared to be on.
All right. We can send out an email with what they said. And
hopefully,
hopefully the next meeting. We will discuss the outreach with the community here and the next. We want to get input from the community, from both communities. Opportunities for that outreach at Art Walk with the ambassadors from China, from Mexico, and the chaperones that come and the ones that go down there too. And also opportunities with the Day of the Dead celebration in town. And we want to firm up the RFQ language and the dates of, we still, the end date for this is still a year out. So we have time to, we can send an RFQ out at the end of this year or in the fall and still give plenty of good time for installation in early 2022.
Fantastic. I would say that we say that we have plenty of time, but as all of us know, Day of the Dead snuck out on us like nobody's business. So I think that we should really develop a plan to let anybody else agree that we need to get involved pretty quickly.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And I think they understand that.
Yeah.
And that's why we gave them the three bullet points that we wanted answers to, so that when we know exactly budget, we know exactly placement, we know exactly what piece of monument they had more interest in.
And at our last meeting, what we came to the table with was quite a bit of research. And it demonstrated some things that you might experience out in the world and the cost related to that. And so really bringing some of these grander ideas to something that is more realistic, that is based upon the number that has been floating around. And so that is what they're taking to their group today. So I think it should be a pretty tight package. Yeah, we should be able to get on the road pretty quick.
Thank you, committee. That was really awesome.
What's that location?
Oh, yes.
Also, after the meeting, we had people stay, and we discussed possibly, they have this idea that they want it to be butterflies for their own reasons. And we discussed maybe getting some resin stamps that we could stamp in the sidewalk. There's a sidewalk that's going to go up, that's going to spiral up and hit a low hill. And you could stamp those into the sidewalk.
There is a beautiful art symbol that I hope gets the.
Well, we haven't investigated yet, but we don't think the resin stamps cost very much. And Steve Renswiler with the parks, the planning parks, said that they were easy and he could do that all day. He could do that anytime. And when you pull up the sidewalk, it gets cracked, and before it knew, he still keeps the stamps, he can re-stamp. So we've discussed the possibility of us as AIPP donating those to the Sister Cities project above and beyond whatever they match, whatever they come up with that we need to match.
Okay,
was fantastic. I just want to say that is great work and we're real focused. You know, really good.
I think that will also free them up from the idea that this gathering place monument gateway thing has to include butterflies, because if we can put them in the sidewalk, then that will open their mind more to a more homogenous community center.
Cool.
I know that one. Snakey.
Susan!
Good job.
Yeah, I don't see a Francis Jasper.
It was, no, it was really.
We also had some ideas for the launch of it as far as gathering data with these, and I think we passed the picture that Angela had of the post-its that was done in front of the White House at one time during the Obama term. And I had seen something similar over the weekend down in Denver, and we thought, well, we could even do that in the shape of a butterfly with different colored post-its. So,
do y'all remember the artist? I mean, I think there's several. The one that we had in
That is the same artist, and her names are Longmont. Amanda Wilshire, she
it was fantastic.
Yeah, her art WD, she did the piece down all along the Greenway with the Volkswagen hood and the dragonfly. Yes,
there's a
same
lot
artist.
Of artists. This would be great.
Yeah, so I mean, it's looking to be a, in between a $20,000 and $30,000 project, likely. And that's completely in her ballpark and would make very good sense. So,
I'm sorry, what location are you talking about? Oregon Park is a new park they're putting in just southeast of here, off of Quebec, and it's a big community park there, and it's with future expansion even more. But it's going to have a off-leash dog exercise area.
A pollinator garden,
a frisbee golf course, a shooting place, a little hill with a spiral walk. It's open space and a big circular, big old lawn. So
it's a big area.
It's a big area.
We have an expected date of when the park will be completed.
They're in their final planning stages right now. They're going to start working on it in the fall.
And they were, and the sisters of these people were okay with it being a little bit.
Well, the thing is, if we can get into a park when they're still building it, then if they need to pour concrete or something for a footing for a gathering place, it's easier to do it then than it is to come in later and dig everything up and bring in the equipment, as you know, and pour the concrete then. So it's better. Plus, we can request electricity in the shelter and. Lights or something. We can request other things. Right?
So. It just became really much more cost effective to go on the in ground.
Of course.
Rather than the things
that would have resilient safeguarding. So yeah, good job. Good. Thank you so much. Both of them great research. Ms. Angela, we don't have Francis here this evening. Can you update us on RSVP?
Who else was at RSVP? Holly, you were. Cindy, you were.
Honestly, I've been through so many meetings, I'm not sure which one that was.
We've been working.
We went over, I think, that last meeting.
Yeah, I think so. Just quickly, Steve Ransweiler came and met with the RSVP group to go through the Nine Dots project proposal and look at all of those locations and identify places where city land is annexed. And that would be an appropriate place for a piece versus something that maybe wouldn't be the best location for X, Y, and Z. And then from that list, the group is going back and prioritizing looking at those locations. In the meantime, I met with senior engineer Alan something with an R to talk to him about the Boston Bridge. Because the Boston Bridge is the next bridge that is going to be going underway related to resilient seafaring. So the Boston Bridge itself is in first round of design, structurally, basically. And then the aesthetic piece of it will come a little bit later. So there's an opportunity to start looking into a project related to that bridge over the next couple of years, as well as some of these changes that's happening in the landscape along the way. Resilient seafaring, as you know, is funded up to Sunset at this point, and then there is some area further to the west that has not on the capital is not funded thus far. So really what we're talking about is up to sunset. But yeah, there's opportunity to sort of get in with the development of that. So yeah, more to come.
Excellent. Thank you so much, Angela.
Yeah.
Mr.
Peter, tell us about our Portland Adventures.
I don't have anything to do with it. I've been
extremely distracted last. So Angela and I met briefly about 2 weeks ago, and she had a little update, but she did kind of fill us in some of the arduous things that you all had to deal with. Or she felt me and myself and I. And so you all want something, so we're looking at some different complications, so she might have an update for us.
So when the group met, Cindy and I went and did another site visit based upon some of Judge Frick's initial his interest in the space. And the truth is that there are a number of spaces that could be addressed, but the one he was initially looking at is a really long wall. It is 16 feet long. But there are some pillars in the way, and it's not very visually appealing, but obvious. So Cindy and I will be going over to Sandstone Ranch to investigate Roy's World. As we understand Roy's World, it's a triptych of Sandstone Ranch, but it's in a place that's quite hidden. So we thought that we would go and see the location and even if it could potentially be relocated. So we're gonna look at that. The second piece of the courtroom is when you first walk in, if you've been in the Safety and Justice Building, and once you pass the security guard on your right, you go in and it actually is this very nice, round, lit area. And while we were there, one of the police officers had come out and said that some of the initial thought about having sculpture in that area is maybe on the floor would not be wise because sometimes there's altercations or there's a lot of people, and so keeping that area, that floor area, open would be his preference. That was very insightful for someone who's in the space every day. So the third thing that the group had looked at is some suspended sculpture. And so that's the way that the group is leaning now. So we're all looking at research. Some of the images that I pulled together about what something like that would cost. Next step is going to be going back to Judge Frick and saying this is the kind of thing that we're thinking. Very abstract, potentially colorful, not a lot of, but also addressing that wall with the sandstone ranch. So there will be something that is potentially landscape and figurative, but maybe something also that's uplifting as well.
I think it's important that we know that when we say next steps, we don't know a lot of us don't know what our next steps are right now, so we be patient and kind with one another. We may not be able to get into the courtroom.
Right.
So I think that it's
the other thing about the sandstone ranch ancient is that they're only open like 4 months a year, one morning a week.
Right.
And so it's not really showing that they had the artwork for the best advantage. So we can
learn to bring it at all.
Cindy, where is it? Because where is it?
Sandstone Ranch?
No, not sandstone. But where is this Roy's World?
It's when you walk in the door of the little house.
Yeah.
It's right behind all the taxidermy animals. On the wall in front of you, you almost can't see it at all.
I mean, and I've been up there a million times, and I can't see.
Yeah, it's three paintings, nice and colorful, of the river from the bluff.
Oh, okay.
And it's really pretty, okay. But you can't see it in.
And so we're thinking of moving it to the court.
At least temporarily, if not. We're going to sum it up and see how it goes.
We need to go and visit it. We don't know if there's a place in Sandstone Ranch for it to move, or what the history is, so a site visit is the next step there.
And we're hopefully doing it next week.
Yeah, it's on the calendar for next week.
So we're gonna move on to AOTM.
Art on the Move.
Back on, Andrew.
Art on the Move, the call is open right now. Last that I checked, We had 16 entries, which is good, not great, but as we all know, artists tend to wait to the last minute. I have had lots of email inquiries about the application, but they haven't applied yet. So encourage folks to go and visit that call. Of course, it's free to apply, and it's open until the 29th. And then if all things stay on track, we are presently scheduled to do our Art on the Move selection April 1st, no joke, at 5 p.m. Now, that being said, if there need to be delays for the variety of reasons there need to be delays, we're not under contract with anyone.
What's
that?
Why wouldn't we be able to do this WebEx?
Yeah, we could do a Zoom.
A Zoom or WebEx?
Yep.
I think one thing to look at is how many of you do not have technology to do that. I think most of us do. There's a WebEx and a Zoom app on our phones. The WebEx app is very easy. I mean, I think that's one of those things that we wouldn't get the food though. So, we could have, Angela and I would go and deliver food to your house.
Just order pizzas for everyone. Here you go.
There you go.
There you go.
But I also know that Jared Poles has said that we groups under 100 are okay as long as we're at a 6-foot distance.
And that's why we're here tonight, right? Yeah. So maybe not buffet style, but I think in the next coming days we will have more information. But right now we're just following what the city is saying, which is following CDC guidelines, which is exactly that. So at this point in time, I think we please keep it on your calendars and Peter.
Yeah, I'm just gonna ask, email you that I
won't. Okay.
We may have a lot more involvement than we originally thought.
We may. Yeah.
That's likely to be the answer. So
Randy?
You have emailed out the link, correct?
The doodle poll or the call?
The call.
Yes. Do you need it again?
Just to be safe, yeah.
Yeah. Please. And I'll just send it to everyone.
Okay, so this is a standby. I don't know how many of you have been in that mode, but the last week we've been in, like, every day is a different story. So, and I'm sure the city is in the same boat.
Yeah.
Excellent. Thank you very much, Angela. Shocker. Go ahead, Angela.
Unless Randy.
Randy, yeah, I feel
we've been going back and forth.
Yeah, we have. Have you?
I have.
So we have a space. It's a town marketplace like last year. Tomas is extremely excited about having it there again this year. The plan, the dates. I guess 8th, which coincides with the art walk, would be the inaugural loading time frame, and then the boxes for 2 weeks for voting. We'll have food and potentially entertainment, like music. Last year we had
and potentially food.
Yeah.
As well as.
And again, it's another one of those things where the community has been so involved in the past that if postponing it 1 month so we can have something live to re-engage the community, we can do that. The timeline of this program is not so drastic that we're beholden to this because of weather or contract or anything along those lines.
We may have to postpone the painting until autumn when it isn't so hot that the painting dries before they can put it
out. I think we just wait. I mean, there's so many different things. Today I heard that the peak of this mess is going to be the end of April, and I heard we're going to be done with it in 3 weeks.
Right.
So you just never know.
Right. And because our community partner was so engaged and very excited to have people back, I think that marriage is also very important and valuable, particularly to this project, because it is so community involved.
Ready? The posters, I know I had a question with the posters. I just need a little bit more clarification. We would allow voting on the posters, or how?
That's the way that it's done in the past, and actually I look around to some of you who have been here a long time. So there's the maquettes, and the maquettes would go on display, and in the past they had moved from locations.
Yes.
Working with Old Town Media, he's prepared to have them on display for the whole time, and just live voting with the maquettes happens there. That being said, we can create posters of the individual pieces, images of them, and have one on display here at the museum. You get a couple of stickers, and you stick a sticker, and I think that that's how Lauren had done it in the past, because I have some of those posters.
We did that at Art Walk, so we would have easels with art on the move, and people that would come up to the booth would place a sticker on that.
Yeah.
I'm not sure how that, unless somebody's there to give out the stickers at the museum, mm-hmm. just see people, you know.
Yeah.
But I don't know.
Yeah.
Unless we can leave the ballots there or something like that.
Does anybody have opinions about how that best worked in the past, or what you liked or didn't like about that process?
It was, the transport was kind of silly.
Yeah, I'd rather not transport boxes.
And that's actual silly. It was just, and the other thing I thought about when we did this the last time was that for people that are visually impaired and people who are in wheelchairs, I mean, to be frank, that's not maybe compliant. And so putting them in posters allows people to use their own ADA compliant or their own resources to be able to blow things up or look at things. That's kind of a silly thing to bring up, but it's something that we probably in the next 10 years will be much more accountable for.
So I just finished our web training through the city, and after next Tuesday, we'll be able to make changes to our website, which also includes the screen reader and the ADA accessibility. I don't know if anyone has visited the City of Longmont website recently. It's just been updated, and it's fantastic. It's far more accessible than it has ever been. And I actually went through the exercise of traveling through a website through a screen reader, and I understand how important that is. So it might even mean making a site or a place on our website in an accessible form where folks could vote on the form.
And if you're someone who's in a wheelchair or someone who's differently enabled, you're going to go into a place and you're going to be like, wow, I can't move you. What are these little boxes, you know? So that's just something to think about for the future.
Are we going to have people vote for one or three or five?
I think that's what the task force is going to be charged with. I do understand that ballot people tried to cheat in the past. So I think that associating an email address, and then when that voting moment comes, that voting night, going through and basically doing an audit of email addresses. I mean, if somebody wants to create bunk emails, then
well, I was thinking that if we had posters in the museum, we'd have a ballot box that the different ballots are, there could be stacks of the different, and people could fill out three mm-hmm. or five that they wanted and put it in one ballot box instead of trying to put dots on it.
That has been the way it was in the past. We have a box in the museum, actually, and a ballot box with ballots so people could vote on their own, but Lauren's able to recognize from the ballot box and stuff.
Yeah.
Is it a handwriting? We could still use the post. Oh, and we allowed for your top three choices. Circle your top three, and that was your vote. And then the top ones. But the posters could also be used as kind of PR. Put one in the museum, one in the library, one in the mall. Here's the boxes. If you're interested in voting, go over to Old Town Marketplace and vote.
Yeah.
Or just
if we're able to vote.
Or, yeah.
We've not been able to do that yet.
So the call for entry in the submission form is live. It's online now on our website. Locations to drop off maquettes for artists are here and at the LDDA. They'll be stored over at the LDDA. Really, I think that coming up with these logistics of the how and the voting, there's still a little bit of time. But because again, this week has just been confusing, the hope was to launch the call for entry for artists and also say, and here's when the voting events are going to be. I think we should wait on that second part, on the promotion piece of it, but certainly put the call for entry out. So you'll be seeing that coming online, and just disseminate it to your friends. A reminder too about Shock Art, we this year cannot engage with a school or a school group that way, because that requires an IGA, and to execute something like that in this time period is not likely. So, but for next year, if you get approached by a school who's interested, we could get that underway now for next year.
Okay. Do you think that it would be possible to have Walmart post, have an exhibit of what we want people to vote on? I know it's right over in Joelle County, but Walmart goes over to Joelle County, right?
Mm-hmm. I don't think that's actually, I don't think that's
feasible. For one reason?
The only thing would be a poster.
I think we do a poster, but I've never seen anything like that. And the other thing is, it is Well County, and like a city commissioner county could vote. If they're like, if I lived by Walmart, I could not be on this commission.
Okay, this is first one.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
But there's several other locations that are not Walmart. We've got King Supers, we've got the library, we've got Whole Foods, which is all because they limit to.
Yeah.
I think Whole Foods might be more open to something like that too, but I don't know.
Yeah, I don't think we've ever explored that idea. Or we've explored, but I don't know if it ever came to fruition where we put posters up to advertise Shock Art and voting.
But I wasn't trying to put it down, I just say,
I'd like to do that.
The fact that Walmart came in, what's their business? Beyond the city limits, and refuses to pay Longmont city taxes, would probably be enough for most of our folks.
It would be super cool, sorry. On the spot, you just made me think of this. And I don't know if this is possible, but on the box, the five boxes or seven we've chosen, it'd be so cool to put a sign on it saying, future site of Shock Art or something. Just people excited.
Yeah.
Oh, that's a great idea.
That's easily done with our vinyl. We have vinyl printing up here.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a great idea. So I think it sounds like the Shock Art Committee should probably get back together. Certainly everyone needs to just push out that call for entry, because again, it is very manual. It's just through our website and submission this way. But we'll reconvene and hone in on some of these details this spring. Digitally or otherwise.
I don't know.
I'm pretty sure before the next meeting, though. I'll ask her.
Okay, let's move on to the strategic plan. Molly?
One more thing. We have the beginning of voting day 8th. Do we have a county voting date?
We do not.
Okay.
Strategic plan, Molly. Okay. Angela and I actually met this week to begin the beginning planning process for strategic planning going forward. And if you remember from the last meeting, we had talked about some of the initial stages of strategic planning involved kind of surveying your constituents, your people in your community, your past commissioners. And so we put together a very quick survey tool to survey our existing commissioners to gather some data about how effective we've been with our plan in the past as well as our guidelines. So that's what just got handed out. And it's really very, it's a very simple process. And if we could all just take a few minutes and complete it quickly. So there's on the left side, there's some statements that are pretty specific to our guidelines for our public places. And on the right side, there's some places where you can check off whether you strongly agree, agree, either agree, or disagree.
couple of statements and then just a few basic questions that help us gather information about the effectiveness of our current mission or self-assessment.
And lastly, I forgot to put a place for you to write your name. So anywhere that there's a blank spot, if you wouldn't mind just writing your name, because some of these questions are specific to you, and we'll keep this amongst ourselves.
Did you say where to put our name?
Just anywhere that there's a white blank space.
Sure.
Thank you.
student here, so. I'm going to apologize to the director. I'm trying to stay on top of this, cancellation of crews I have involved in, work with. My son, he was also in prison.
How close are we?
We need another minute?
Thank you. I know we kind of sprung that on you, but that wasn't intentional.
Yeah, I would have, we would have been maybe better to do this online.
Don't want you to think too hard, just be honest.
Because I can probably should have said, I'll just let it go on.
Be honest and don't worry about her feelings because, it's.
Yeah, I just want to thank you.
Some of the questions that we had for the survey were really just to develop food for thought for us as individuals, specifically how we can, what our passions are and how we can benefit from our campuses.
But what if it's sad and we use one?
What's it going to do with people?
Yeah, this is all a part of strategic planning, so it helps when you're doing your strategic plan to understand what people's passions are and how they feel about the commission that they're serving on. So the next step obviously would be to do some surveying of the community as well as past commissioners to look at our effectiveness. Angela has some, I'm sure, other ideas. I'm not sure how far we want to go with sharing them.
And why do we have to put our name on it?
Well, because some of this says what are your strengths and you have an opportunity to give some ideas, and if you have a great idea, I'm like, who thought that? But the other big point is, as a number of you know, you're going off because this is your second term and you're at term limit, so we have likely 4, potentially 5 new commissioners coming on board. And so some of these answers will help do the best job in orienting our new commissioners. We also had a couple of ideas of a buddy system, so a commissioner who has spent some time and a new commissioner coming on board. So I don't foresee as many questions, so we can get somebody up to speed so we can keep that momentum. But I'm sure that there are other ideas that you have that obviously we're not going to think of. So
I have
one
that.
Yes.
I just thought.
You want to be a buddy?
No, I was.
So, yes, I mean, whenever. So, thank you. All right.
So, another one of the tools, just really quickly, that got handed out on the front table was a piece of paper that is called a project charter. And this is really just a very simple tool once we're going into a new project, to put some of the initial ideas and the thoughts about what needs to go into that project down on a piece of paper. And this kind of helps organize a project and develop a timeline as you go forward. And so this is a very static tool. We can change it if we need to, but it gives us just some guidance about how we're going to approach projects and how we're going to put them together. So you can see it has some places for key members. It's actually a part on the back where once we generate and see a new project that we sign off on it with an executive.
Smart goals.
Smart goals are another whole part. So new projects going forward, we're going to work through this form. We can do it as a group, we can do it as individuals. It may look daunting, but it really just helps to more solidify what we're doing.
So I did look into this, and you only have to take one year off. But that's not to say, and I'll have to look back at guidelines and charter, etc., not this charter, obviously, about participation. You can volunteer. You can come to the meetings. You just don't get a vote. But inclusiveness happens in all kinds of ways, right? So yes, you should keep coming. Just keep.
Your book club or VIP?
Awesome. And as you look at this, if you want to take another copy, please do. If you see something glaring and you're thinking about the project that you're working on and you're saying, it's missing, or that's the wrong word, or, you know, it's, while yes, of course, it's, it looks very nice and it looks like it's, it is going to work, there might be some massaging. So, and thank you, Holly, because she's...
Holly is great.
Yeah, and she's a Monday morning meeting kind of gal.
So
me
you're
too.
Currently an administrator over a task force, or you're leading one, and you already have a project that's ongoing. If you want to try this out, that might be a good way for us to look to see what kind of changes we need to make right off the bat. And certainly if you have questions about any of the specifics, I'm happy to try to answer those as well. Thanks, Molly. That's a great tool. We appreciate that. May we move on?
Yes.
All right. Maintenance.
So I wish I could tell you that I have the maintenance spreadsheet done, but I don't. Our registrar is about to go on maternity leave any moment. So she is cross-referencing all of our session numbers and getting it into a nice pretty document for that. But that will be coming on just in time for us all to go and do our maintenance check. So you might want to start thinking about which works you might want to be assigned to. And also I would encourage you, I don't remember who I was having a conversation with, about choosing something that's not in your backyard.
Yeah.
Or maybe go onto the artwork archive and select something that you haven't seen before. Go down and see if you can count 101 faces and GPS all of them for me.
One thing that is really cool, maybe your first year on the commission, go see things in your backyard. You may not have seen them,
no.
Didn't even know where they were there. That's what I did. And then the second year, I went a little bit broader. And the third year, I went a little bit broader. Because that way, because even like, I didn't know there were so many things in my own backyard.
Mm-hmm. No. So that will be coming underway certainly this spring. And so think about what you want to sign up for. The Unity Project, we are under contract with Mario Echevarria. And of course, again, because he has to start with... The structure, there's a word, stabilizing the structure, and that has to do with adhesive, so it has to be a number of warm days when he does that, but he is Johnny on the spot and ready to go. I have been working with Macy May about capturing some of that on video, so we can start getting some of these projects that we're doing visible to the community through our Channel 8 and YouTube options, so that's very exciting. And then the pieces that we will need to relocate. We talked about it the last time around, and this just came to light when RSVP group met with Steve Ransweiler. So Tully's Details of Nature and the Listening Stone will need to be relocated, but that is not nearly as time sensitive as gathering enough people. So while you are out in the community and you are walking your dog around, if you could go, please go visit that piece and then think about a place where it would be appropriate. A number of places have come out. Dickens, of course, would be maybe an appropriate place. The odd thing about that, of course, is they just finished that park, and I don't know what the deinstallation and reinstallation is going to look like. It will be extensive.
Are you in the top 10 places in your own mind?
Well, yeah, but what do you think? You know.
And question?
Yeah.
Do we have any idea, does it have to be in water?
I don't know. Those are good questions.
Does it, what kind of...
What
kind of
substructure does it have?
Don't know.
That we
well, I mean, I do know.
It really does.
It does, but I think if even if we just all start, anybody who's interested going out and looking into the community so we have something to bring to the table, and I'll contact the artist because I really need to know a little bit more from Steve. He says that the reason that I have to move, I don't know if we talked about this, is the Army Corps of Engineers is likely going to be doing a levee project. So we are beholden to, of course, that project. and it will have to move because of that. So,
and we'll get no notice. We'll get light week.
He said we'll know that it's coming, but right now we know it's coming, yeah. Right? So I think the next step is getting as much accurate information as I can before I go to the artist and start asking questions. So if we can do some preliminary work in location searching at the same time that I'm getting some of these specific questions, then when we get the task force together, it'll be a, you know, marriage of the minds.
So we started out with kind of like this broad thing, and then maybe next month we consider like narrowing it down. Because I'm like, if I don't have like direct orders to where to go and what we have available.
Yeah.
So maybe we can come up with a list of locations we all think about.
I'm going to operate on the idea that it has to be near water for it to work, because it has to press.
Yeah, I think that if it's not in water, how do the guts work?
Yeah.
I mean, has anybody visited the piece recently? So.
But I know it has guts.
It does. It has. It, I mean, obviously, it works with weight, and then there's a lever that engages the component.
I mean, probably you can go into a big hole, but that is a whole another risk.
So my suggestion would also go look up these pieces online. If you have not seen them, or you have a good amount of, they must be old times you've seen them all, and then explore your options.
Yes.
And then maybe we can come back with a few things, and then we can consider starting a message.
Yeah, I think that those are the questions that I need to have answered. But what I will do is I will send some links to these pieces with their locations. So as you decide to go and explore into the world, the listening stone needs to be moved near water because the river is now rerouted differently.
And that's a hard one, because it's so hard to know that place, that operate, that location.
Yeah. So I will send you the location of these, and then just encourage you to get on out there. Okay, sounds good.
You can take a field trip.
Yeah.
That's fun.
Excellent. So let's kind of in general put that in the back of your mind, and then can you, I'm not sick, can you put it on the agenda for?
Yes, we'll just table it, and I will actually make it a project. Because it needs to move out of maintenance, it actually is a project.
Hey, art
walk,
my friend.
Okay, so administrator's report, really nothing more than everything that's on our agenda, with the exception of, are we interested in participating in art walk? It's $300. I'm going to buy
you
a booth.
Yes.
So I think we
need to make a motion.
We
need to
make a motion.
I
move
that
we participate in art walk and pay $300 to do so.
Do we have a second? All in favor?
Aye.
All opposed? Thank you.
Brings $300 too.
What's that?
We didn't have discussion, you're right, sorry.
Oh, that's okay. I'm,
that's a good question.
Yeah.
That's a really good question. So Art Walk now falls under, it is its own entity, but it is managed by Firehouse.
Okay.
And they are giving us the nonprofit rate. And in an ideal world, we will have shop art boxes in Old Town Marketplace, and we'll ask them to generously allow us to have our booth across from, so we can point and direct people to go and vote in person.
Just so you know, I do know my routes, and we should have had a discussion before we voted. I apologize. Yes.
So is that $300 each art walk, or is that the art
marks? There's only one this year, correct?
There's two. There's one May, and then there's another one in September. And yes, it is per event.
And we only voted for one?
Yes.
Right?
They supply anything. We bring our own tent, right?
Yeah, that was the first thing that I did with y'all in the fall, and we did those tiles, and we had a line. The kids totally, the adults too, they really enjoyed that. So we did something crafty. We were getting crafty, so maybe we can talk about getting crafty again. But if we have shock art going on, just an introduction to the program and what we're doing, plus shock art, is probably enough to talk about.
Fantastic.
And maybe Sister City.
And Sister City.
Yeah. We should, and we could ask them if they're, I don't know if they're.
Angela,
yes.
Would you like one of us to, because I think it would be very appropriate if we do meet next month. Thank you.
Yes, I will disseminate that via email.
Yeah.
Great.
And we'll bring a hard copy, and then we can also bring a, put it online so we can sign up.
Great.
It's actually a really fun event.
Yeah, it's very fun. There are so many people who really engage.
And since they've changed things around and made things fewer, it's pretty cool. Mm-hmm. How about news business? I would say that just Front Range Community College has a huge arts program, and we were losing one of our biggest projects that we've had for 9 years called Reconstructing the Past. We still may have our event at, we interviewed Native American women. Our art department made projects around Native American women, and now we won't have that camaraderie. So we will have an event at Left Hand in April, hopefully. So I will send you, I would love to have a copy. It's pretty powerful. The students interview women, and then the drawing class does artwork around those interviews after reading them. That's my thing.
One park that I don't think has any artwork in it yet is fairly new park in Renaissance. It's called Dry Creek Park. It's right by Silver Creek High School. And it has water.
And it's called Dry Creek. Sorry.
Everything's called Dry Creek.
Yeah, because we're all
guys. And then my other thing was, I know you've had a park asking everyone if they have the ability to meet online. Do y'all have the ability? Like, there's also, there's Skype.
We have Skype, we have WebEx, we have Zoom.
So right now, Azri and Noah are on Zoom right there. You can wave at them. It is an application. There is an opportunity, I believe, for you to phone in. So,
like WebEx has a place where you can call in, you don't even have to have a camera.
Is it free?
Yeah.
Web?
Well, I bet you the city already has an account.
Yeah, we've got WebEx.
WebEx?
But we have to, it would.
We should explore it.
There, you have that conference room that we used to meet in over at the DSC that has a camera.
When we did our interviews, yes, yeah. Now that those we were able to use WebEx.
Yeah. There's a couple of conference rooms around the city that have the camera.
So if you don't have a camera on your phone, you don't need it, you can call in.
But you just don't call.
Mm-hmm. I think the concern also would be if we decided to do that with Art on the Move, if you didn't have a camera, or weren't able to be able to see the work.
Oh, I'm going to be making the PowerPoint presentation ahead of time, so I can just send it ahead of time.
Yeah.
And all of the voting, we can get that locked down. And I will have time to investigate this, and this is certainly a priority because.
And I think I'll have more time now that I'm not on the
camera. Yeah. So we'll figure out how to do this. I mean, it's a visual arts for crying out loud. We can meet in that way. So.
Any other commissioner comments?
Yes.
Yes.
Oh, that's not here, is it? We have not, but I will inquire. We have not heard back from them. So the latest was, of course, at our last meeting, they were introducing you to a potential project to see if we were interested in working with them. And then they were going out to see if there were other partners who would be interested in partnering and doing funding with us.
I don't think we even talked about the motion of being interested, but I don't think that's where we're at yet.
I don't think so.
Angela and I met, we both thought it was a really, really exciting opportunity for this commission.
I have to go to London. Last month, seats. And if you come in as well, there's a question for you about a conversation I regularly for lunch again. And you come in as well, all this construction has been going on, and now it's done, and it's really evolving.
all my home is worried, like, wow, we're going to have pollen, and we're not going to know the difference, so.
Great. That's awesome.
So I'll put that under new business.
Just as you drive into town before you get to Full Street, so there's cannabis, which is where I have much more. Check in there and then handle it. You just go straight into town.
I think even looking at some of the things online, I did some research as far as most cities have things like this. We're just kind of catching up with the bigger metropolises.
Metropolises.
Another comment I would have is I just think that Angela's doing an amazing job.
No, it is. This is a group effort.
Oh, and we're that, if you think about what she's on and what she's taken on. Kim, do you have any comments? We kind of left you out.
I want to backtrack on the project's location. There's details of nature ones that are along the bike path there, is that what
you're talking
about? Oops, sorry. Yes, those are them.
And how many of those are they? Would they all have to move to get there?
Yes. How many are those? I know,
is
I looked at it.
Two, three, like
there's
four,
a number.
Four or five. Okay, so,
and they have to move because they're changing where that sidewalk
where
is.
Where the sidewalk is.
They just moved to the new sidewalk.
Yeah. The only other thought I had, because since I've come on it, all I've heard about is how gardening makers want something. I've yet to hear of anything moving towards that direction, so maybe something.
Didn't they decide that wasn't a feasible thing?
Garden Acres went through renewal some number of years ago, and Parks approached Art and Public Places and said, we're doing park renewal, are you interested? And at that time, there were too many projects to accommodate. That being said, if you've been to that park recently, there's a very nice entrance. It's highly visible, so I don't think that it's out of the... there's also a bridge there. We looked at that park, so... it would not be difficult to install an appropriate piece for that space.
I think there's water there, too.
I think so, too. Yeah.
Susan, maybe you should take a pee.
Okay. I'll make sure I go to the room.
You have to make sure that you can go take a pee, because I think there's some water there.
Yeah. I will.
That's like clear on the other side of town.
What was the price tag on that mural, Angie?
$158,000. It is massive.
Yeah.
This is what you're talking about, Peter?
Yeah.
Never mind. So they had a giant, I think it's 6-story parking garage that is just a giant concrete bunker. And initially, the project was a steel figurative piece that had these flowing arms. Well, then the cost of steel went up, and the artist team wasn't able to accomplish the work. And so they broke the contract, rewrote the RFQ, and got that piece. The artist is Daas, D-A-A-S. I can send you this, too, if you like. He spends his time between Florida and Japan, and he came to the commission with a number of different in Loveland and Colorado-inspired landscapes. And so on the one side is figurative with a little girl who, or actually it's a child, very open, and who's painting, and then on the other side there's a chickadee
really cool. You can look it online.
It's beautiful.
Or go down.
Yeah.
And the commission surprised the city when they invested so much and were told that really you shouldn't do graffiti seal, or really you shouldn't do it, and it came about that they sealed the entire thing for UV, and it has a 25 to 30 year lifespan on the protection. And the artist also provided the city with a basically a paint by numbers. So in the future, for maintenance, they can remove the sealant, go back, freshen it up, and then reseal it.
I think we've learned the hard way that we will be standing outside of anything. Like, we'll all take, like, shifts to make sure nobody messes
up our stuff. And so for 9th and Alpine, the police officers did say, we'll just close the trail completely and basically protect it in between.
You and I already promised we camp together. I live right down the street. We got bathrooms pretty close. We can.
Yep.
I said it would be like camping out for concert tickets.
It's very hip.
We can make a party out of it because I'm good at that.
But I did run into Officer Arnie, and she and the other officers who have been involved in the case are very excited that we are not just going to paint it white and give up on it. So. That's really encouraging.
Great.
Okay.
Are there any other commissioner comment?
One more. I saw Melanie in King Super. She says hi to everybody.
Aww.
And she misses us. And Marshall?
Yeah. I'm not a commissioner, but I just wanted to say this is my first meeting.
You're welcome. We should have welcomed you back.
That's okay. I just wanted to say how much I enjoyed it. I sit on a number of boards and commissions, and a lot of rubbing snooze all the Senior Citizens Advisory Board is not, and you guys are not, and I'm really happy about that.
Are you on the house?
Thank you.
No, I'm not.
Talking to you. See, we're a lot more fun than that. Right?
Yeah. I have to go to a couple of them, but yeah, I'm not on board pleasantly.
Thank you for being here.
Yeah. Thank you, Marsha.
Yes. It's a working board.
Yeah,
these folks are.
We're really excited to have you here and be active. And welcome. Are there any other comments, concerns, questions for Angela, Ken?
Oh, I do think of one more thing. Sorry. As you know, of course, I say it again, nominating committee is coming up in April. So think about if you would like to take a role in one of those ways. And also, because we will have a number of seats available, the application for commissioners is online. So if you have someone or know someone or don't know someone.
If you're interested in an officer position.
If you're interested in an officer position, but also if someone in your community is interested in a chair at the table, those applications are online. So, yes. And we're looking to diversify and reach different kinds of people out within our community. Oh, and one of the other things that you receive is the demographic form from the city. So our board should mirror that. So age and ethnicity and all of those things. That's a perfect example of what we strive to look like, right? So yeah, good data there. All right.
If you want to see something else, have a look at that Boulder County trend report. And the differences between Longmont and Boulder and Erie, Erie and Lafayette. Really fascinating.
All right.
Y'all are awesome. Thank you very much.
Somebody.
And move to adjourn. Oh, move to adjourn or not?
Somebody.
Someone.
Peter.
All right. All in favor?
All
opposed? Excellent.
Good meeting.
Guess what? We made up for the time that we lost last Angela. We owe you 36 minutes.
We're good.